In this video, we'll take a close look inside the EPEVER charge controller. This is a 3210 EPEVER. When connecting, you could see the symbols on the front, the solar, the battery, the load, common, and temperature sensor. To open this charge controller, it has four screws at the back of it. You remove the four screws. And you would turn the charge controller over. Now, the top panel comes out, which is this gray top from the black cover. But you have to be aware of the screen. It has a ribbon inside it. So you would lift and turn this. Is the screen, the ribbon that connects the screen. This is your connection point. Those are the fuse, 30 amp fuse. This is a 30 amp charge controller. When connecting, if you blow your fuse, you would have to unsolder the fuse and put a speed connector in there, so you would plug your fuse in. You could either remove the ribbon if you want to detach the screen, remove the ribbon from here, or take out these four screws. Now, to remove the ribbon, there is a gray tab on either side. You take your nails or a screwdriver and pull it up, pull the other side up, and the ribbon will come out. Do not pull on the ribbon to take it out. If you're uncomfortable with that method, you take it out on the four screws. The only thing at the bottom of these four screws is this push button. This won't come out because it's glued onto the case. To take out, if you have a blown fuse, or if you want to check your MOSFETs, you would take out these screws. Mine has four screws. 1, 2, 3, 4. You would take out these screws, and then this would detach from the black case. Now, bear in mind, that won't come out, and that cable is very, very hard. So, taking it out, you would have to flip. Once you release it, you'd have to flip it over. You also have to keep in mind that whenever you take out these four screws and you lift this panel up, you must have thermal paste to put the MOSFETs back in place. Yeah, as I was saying, you must have thermal paste to put this back on the board, and it comes with a little protection. Do not put the board back on the heatsink without thermal paste or without putting this. That's also a thermal, but it's somewhat plastic back. If you put the MOSFETs directly onto this, it will burn, and that could shock you. There is an isolator between the heatsink and the MOSFETs to protect you. I won't be disconnecting this, but for you to take it out, you have to take out this screw, these two screws. This one is black. The others might be silver or whatever color. Once you see the four screws, or it depends on the amperage of the charge controller, it may have more MOSFETs to it. Now, remember, when you're taking off the case, lift it and turn. Do not pull up. You will damage the ribbon. Although this, once you have the MT50, this will work without that. You just have to plug the MT50 in. But remember, be gentle with it. To get this board off the heatsink, take out these four screws. There are MOSFETs underneath here. If you put your tester on the fuse here, here and there, on either one of them, you would get continuity. If you put it, I cannot remember right now which one of the holes, I think it's the positive. If you put it on the positive, put your one lead on the positive and connect here, you will get continuity. That means once you get in continuity, your fuse is good. This one has a problem. It worked for 3 days and stopped. I test everything. Everything seems to be okay. I don't know if it's a firmware issue or what, but I'm hoping to get it going. I bought another 4210, which is a bigger one, and I would just have this one here until I could get it going. If you find this information was helpful, please like, subscribe, comment, and I'll see you on the next one. Thank you and goodbye.